Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. As you can see, I'm quite on a dangerous adventure at the moment. Oh, that was not what I wanted to do. Get back on the rope. There we go. We're gonna go and look for a few of those metal flowers, and I think we're pretty close to one right now. There we go, there's one. There we go. Thank you very much.
It's beautiful in its way.
So this one is pretty close to where we started the game, actually, right next to Rost's cabin. There we go. I'm just gonna see if there's anything there for us, and I'll see you guys there in a second. Because close to his house, there should be a monument now that indicates Rost's grave. I'm actually looking for it right now. Because it seems to be, might be in the front over here somewhere. Because I know it was added.
Look, he built all this.
Yeah, okay, there goes the dialogue again.
Alone. So many memories. It's not home anymore. Not without Rost. There's nothing for me here anymore.
So there we go. I think this is his grave, yeah.
Rost, I'm sorry I didn't come sooner. When you said goodbye, I told you I'd find you. Track you down. Well, looks like you did it after all. Went somewhere I can't follow. I should have known you'd be watching. At the proving. Looking out for me. There for me when no one else was. Like always. One last time. Thank you, Rost. I won't waste what you've given me. I promise. I'll make you proud.
We sure will.
I've been trying to puzzle it out, but nothing makes sense. The killers came after me because I look like this... a woman. Older, with short hair. But why? And what's the connection? If she's my mother, then... she didn't look Nora, but if she lives inside the mountain, how could the killers know about her? The more I learn, the less I understand.
Go on. Well, we can actually go further.
I need to track down Olin, an outsider. He was at the festival the night before the proving. Somehow, the killers saw me through his focus. And he knew it. He could have warned me. But the killers, they've got his family. Even so, he's responsible for everyone's deaths. For yours. When I find him, well, he's gonna tell me everything he knows. And he's gonna pay.
I wonder if you can keep coming back here to talk to Rost and tell him what you've been through.
It's time to find Olin. I'll try to visit before too long.
Goodbye, Rost. Okay, that was nice. A nice little tribute to Rost. But now, we're gonna head towards our next metal flower because I want to make this a bit of a collector's episode. And let's see if we can't find any interesting dungeons while we're going around as well.
Snow chill, itches.
So next up should be another metal flower. I'm not really sure if it's wide out in the open here. Or if I got... oh, what the hell? Oh, it's right over there. How do I get down without killing myself? Gonna have to take the long route. That was easy again. I thought every one of those metal flowers would be inside of a dungeon. But apparently I'm wrong. So if that's the case, I'm just gonna quickly skip through all of these. And I'll just let you know when I find one, but I'll those would be more involved than this, since the first two we found were both in a sort of dungeon.
Need them soon enough.
There we go, some more medicine, and then that's... Don't know why it's over here, because we know it's right over there, because we've seen it. There it is. Holy shit, that makes a creepy noise. Thank you very much. So that's 4 out of 10 metal flowers. Wait. No. Okay, so we need to still find the rest of them. So, on to the next one. So, took a stride to the next one. We should be pretty much here. And this should be a vantage point. I don't know. I thought vantage points would always be tall necks. How does this even work? Do we need to climb the tree? What? How does this... Oh. Ah, it's probably over there. We need to get up there and then we'll probably unlock more of the area, I suppose. I'm just randomly climbing rocks here. Hoping that I get to where I need to go. Okay, and then over there. And then we're at the vantage point.
A vantage. Another message from the past.
Oh. Really? What's here? Or do I just... Access vantage cache. Press triangle to play the vantage audio.
Apocashit Storm Tour, Day 2. My father guest lectured here. A 300 level military
Holy shit.
Course on the age of human air power. Might as well have been teaching medieval siege tactics. I was 8 when he died.
Oh. Wow. This is cool. So the building is still there, but... Huh. That is very cool. Air Combat Academy. Interesting. Let's go check that out.
Might regret this.
There is a corrupted zone in there. But let's take it out, because it shouldn't be that high of a level of corrupted zone. Yeah, it just looks like scrappers. And that's it. So if I can, I'm gonna try and take them out stealthily. And just whistle at every one of those scrappers. So nobody else seems interested for now. If I just brutally murder this scrapper over here. I also start to realize that I can't override corrupted machines. So that's part of the reason why I failed in previous attempts. I don't need to try and take out these guys. And then whistle when we're closer. Then there seems like there's 2 more of these guys. And slash. And then take his call. And seems like there's only 1 more left then. Unless there are some others hiding, of course. Get over here, you bastard. And stab in the face. Straight in the face. Take all his metal burn, because of course it's a priceless piece of loot. Let's see, how many are there left? Seems like it's only that one, and he turns around in a second, so... Oh, he comes up to the staircase. Don't know how he doesn't spot me here, but... Okay. So that should give me the opening I need. Oh, even the stealth animation changes when you go up the stairs. Need to be careful about the corruption, though. And there we go. Cleared out the corrupted zone. There we go, more metal burn. And we got 5,000 experience for that. That's really nice. What else is here? Seems like ancient debris. Do another toothpick. Ancient toothpick and ancient keyring. And I think that's pretty much it. So let me... That's pretty much it. I'm gonna check out the map and we'll head towards the next point. So back near the Tall Neck and the vessel. I think we kind of missed that vessel before, or actively tried to avoid it, because I thought there were sawtooths in the neighborhood. It actually sounds like it could be the case. There is a watcher here. There's one over there as well. If I just move around a bit, should be able to stab it. There we go. Been a while since we've seen watchers, but the vessel should... Oh. Wait a second. We should be right on top of it, but... Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay, I've been looking around for this for...
I'll shake it out later.
The past 10 minutes, and apparently it's on the other side of the ruins, near the water. There it is. Ancient vessel arches take all. Let's check it out really quickly. A cracked and battered vessel once dear to the old ones seems to show the terrain of the Gatelands. Sets of ancient vessels can be traded in. So, there we go. The second one of our set. Moving on. Ooh, and it seems like I can climb this building to get towards our next vantage point. So let's try and do this. There we go. Follow the obvious yellow lines. And now get in, I suppose. Okay. Ooh. Place is dark, but we need to get higher. So dropping down in, I suppose. There is stuff over here, which is good. I can sell that. Now, where do I need to go? She doesn't seem to be doing this. Ah, there we go. Okay, that's good. This is where we came from, right? Yeah, okay. Maybe we can climb up further. Oh, this is annoying. This looks... Ah, there we go. We can climb up. Okay. And then over there. Climbing further up. Ooh, gold. And then to the side in slow motion. There we go. Oh, I almost thought she didn't... She wasn't going to grab that. And the vantage point is right there, so we're pretty much where we need to be. And more loot.
Another message from the ancient past.
There we go. Oh, snap. Ooh, we actually see a city this time.
Apocalypse Storm Tour Day 4. It's hard to believe Metallurgic International used to be headquartered in this dreary old ziggurat. Why, its office was on the second floor from the top. If Emmett had a policy against workplace romances, he probably wrote it.
Okay then. So this is where the offices were, apparently. And now there's practically nothing left. Yeah, there's two buildings, and those two buildings are kinda still there. But that's pretty much it. Wow. Okay then, another vantage point. I do like how these vantage points work, because they kinda teach you a bit more about the world. So let's rappel down. I almost fell off there. That would have been horrible. And there we go. Back on solid ground. So next up, I think, is another vessel.
Scrapes.
Oh, and I think I... Because the marker is over there, but I think I stumbled on the vessel automatically. There we go. Wayfarer's ancient black bracelet as well, which is, of course, a watch. But it seems like it's to the south of the icon, which is good for me. So Wayfarer's. I do want to look... at how it looks. Not something... Hearts Wayfarers? Yeah, Hearts Wayfarers. Okay then. Seems like we're still missing one more vessel in the set, and it seems like it's the first one as well. I also think that this is the bandit camp I already cleared out, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, okay, so next up is gonna be another vantage point, I think. So next vantage point, not that far from the bandit camp we freed in one of the earlier episodes. And I'm do wondering how I'm gonna get up here, because I don't see a real path here.
Here, I can look into the past with my focus.
Yes, I know. Ah, there we go. We could grab onto that. And a bit more supplies. Ooh, there's a lot of stuff in here. Thank you very much. And then the vantage cache. Oh, wow.
The pocket shit storm tour, day 3. I was 13. I broke in and vandalized this place. Me and that kid, I think his name was Star. It was my first arrest. A real banner day for the Mahdi family. What a messed up kid I was.
Kind of looks like a museum or a city hall or something like that. Really nice building. If we remove it, oh wow. Yeah, you can actually see it a bit. So that's where the bandit camp is now located. Interesting. Huh. We do keep learning more and more, so let's see what's up next. Give me a second. I started my ascent of the mountain here because the next thing we're gonna try and get is one of those figurines. And they seem to be on top of the mountain here. I'm wondering if those are ledges. She was stretching her hand, so that meant I got a shot at that. Okay, so that was a first step. Ooh, this one looks... Does she do that automatically? No, she doesn't. No, she doesn't. Can I get back up? Yeah, thank you. And now she's doing it automatically. Okay, that's a bit weird. Now we're going over here. Seems that those drawings are really interesting. So they're really colorful as well. Jump, and then jump, jump, jump. So the first jump I need to do myself, and otherwise she's going to do that automatically. To the left. Ooh, wow. The animations are really cool sometimes. A lot more dynamic than I've seen in Uncharted and the like. Then across the rope, I presume. I'm not gonna rush this. Definitely not gonna rush. Wow. This view, though. Wow, look at that. And I think we're already where we need to be. Yeah, that's one of those figurines. Banook artifact, my claim.
Looks like one of those Banook sculptures.
Wow, that was an echo. First Banook figure found, trophy. A wooden artifact left in offering under a tribal mark, along with a strip of parchment bearing handwritten glyphs. Sets of such artifacts can be traded in Meridian for valuable rewards. So I'm missing one more vessel, one more vantage point, and one more figure. Interesting. So the vantage points are in order though, so we're still missing the ones that seem logical for some reason. Oh my god, this game is so pretty. So the last thing I want to do today is find a metal flower. Shouldn't be too far off, so give me a second. Should be over there in the mountains somewhere. So we're actually pretty close. Well, we're right next to the Eclipse camp that we cleared out, where we, horribly failed being stealthy by that riding down. And it seems like, the metal flower is just right here. So I kind of missed it when we were here. Yeah, jump over it. That's not really how we do that, right? So that's our fifth metal flower mark one. So we're 50-50 on those. I think I'm going to try and get one more vessel, which should be to the north of here. So give me a second. So the next vessel should be pretty close to where we fought in the Ring of Metal. So we're in the area where those few bandit camps were that we cleared out one after the other in the one episode. So this is where the marker is, but I'm just looking around a bit to see where the vessel itself is. I think if I just stand over here, should be able to spot the loot cloud. Although something is trying to kill me already. Is this a corrupted zone as well? Or are these guys just here? They're dumb. That's something. Oh yeah, I'm taking corruption damage. And then we have... I'm just... Oh yeah, there it is. There it is. Okay, so I just need to take out... You know what? I don't really need to take out. He's not gonna... He's not gonna try and attack me, I think, from this distance. So, the ancient vessel USRC. So that means, is that one of those first? No, it's of the second set. Which makes this kind of annoying. Huh. So there's one more vessel I don't really have on my map then, because I have another vessel pretty close by.
What'll this one hold?
Maybe I should check that one as well, because it's, yeah, it's pretty close over here. That one is of the second set as well. Maybe get the metal flower on the way as well. And that one is of that second set as well. I think they just keep most of those out of your reach. Unless... Oh, there's a lot here as well. So you might not be able to complete all the sets. Yeah, because there's 5 on this column. And then, yeah, there's not anything else nearby. So yeah... Just gonna head to the metal flower and then the last vessel, and then I'm gonna call it a day. So should be easy to find since they're mostly surrounded by flowers usually. Although I don't really. Oh, must be over there. Ooh, that's a sawtooth. That's a complete sawtooth that's been taken out here. And there's the scrappers. Just gotta stay out of their way. Gonna stay out of their way. So where would the flower be? Where would the flower be? Oh, it's right over there. I just paused it. Just gonna take it. There we go. And I'm just gonna hide behind this pillar and we'll head towards that last vessel. So we should be nearby the vessel. Ah, there it is. Okay. There we go, inside this building. So usually they're pretty easy to find. And that's the KZ vessel. Probably, yeah, the second set as well. So that's a bummer. I thought I could finish up a set in here in this episode. But yeah, I'm also gonna try to not do too many of these episodes because there's, of course, a lot of collectibles. And it's not that interesting to look at. But the vantage points, I think, provided a bit more insight in how this... this world came to be, because we saw how it was before everything went to shit, and we get a bit of an explanation next to it as well. So yeah, I'm gonna take a little break. When we get back, I'm gonna head towards the Banuk village. It's one of the side quests, and we're pretty close to the entrance of their frosty area, and we're gonna do that in the next episode. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again, enormously for watching, and hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!